And hopefully you share some shares. So, we're gonna have a few minutes for talk back. And I recognize some of you were at the other performance. So I will try to ask different questions this time. But first, let's start off with everybody introducing themselves, your name, what grade you're in, what school you go to. While we start with Adani.
My name is Adani Woods. I'm in 10th grade at Francis McCain.
I'm Victoria Bradley.
Well, I'm
Victoria Bradley. I am in 8th grade. I'm 13.
I'm Taylor Williams. I'm in the 10th grade and I go to Arts Academy in the Woods.
My name is Shannon Harper. I'm in 11th grade. I go to Southfield High.
My name is Brandon Tilwells. I'm in the 12th grade. I'm also going to college and I go to Southfield High.
My name is Matthew Dean. Some people call me Matt for short. I also go to Southfield A&T and I'm in 11th grade going to school.
Great, very good. So, now that you had a chance to, you've been involved in this play about 2.5, almost 3 months. And I would like each of you to tell me what has been your takeaway from this experience, from this play. And I think I'm gonna start with Matt first.
Okay, so my takeaway was how we learned how to act in a small space. For me, that was kind of difficult, but what was more difficult was the fact that we had to act out multiple characters. Small space, no changes, no big scenes or anything.
My takeaway is that we, same thing as Matt, last time you guys were here, basically, we had like such a smaller space. And so like now, I feel like I don't need a big space or a big stage to do good. All you need is just one, an audience, and then confidence to really do good.
So a lot like I guess with lines and stuff like that, again with the spacing, because like at first I was like, I don't know how we're gonna do this, but again with blocking also, because since we're talking, we're doing all this stuff, it's like, oh, don't have your back to the crowd, don't have your side to the crowd, make sure they see you, project your voice and things like that.
From this experience, I learned how much I have to, what we all have to like feed off of each other. Feed off each other's energy and stuff when we act. So,
what I took away was the lines, like working with lines and different characters, and having switch back and forth.
Okay. Most of you guys were here last time we did this. So. I kind of still don't know what to do when like you forget your line or someone else forget your line. We're just kind of stuck waiting for it. What do you now?
So
I still don't know what to do. I still got.
Okay. So all of you, except for Adane, had to deal with the different characters. So if you could talk to me a little bit about what was your approach to how you try to create the different characters. Now, Adane, I would like you to talk about, and Stan, when we get to you, what you had to do as far as to appear as though you were listening. How did you stay in the moment, throughout the play? Okay, so let's start with that again.
Okay, so I had basically two main characters, and it was David and Mr. Marcus. So basically for Mr. Marcus, it was, relatively short. So I kind of just acted how I thought a dad would, maybe someone who was a little bit older and had a sense of responsibility and drive and focus. So I kind of took from that aspect. And as far as David, I'm young, I've fallen in love a couple of times, so I know how that feels. So I kind of just channeled that energy and used that in my portrayal of David.
Well, for me, you taught me like going back there like a lot to like change and stuff like that. Well, okay, so for Tommy, he was more nice and more calm and more just energetic. And so it was like, you really, it depends on the costume, like what I'm wearing, or like what I'm acting with in that scene. So like with Tommy, I had to be up with her because I had to always be nicer than her, like I am in real life. And so then, and then with, in the classroom, I had to be hyper, I had to be, you know, technically like really hyper student. I know I didn't want you guys to think that I was the same person every time, so I had to like try really hard to like make myself seem like I was a different character. And did I do a good job at that? No?
Yes. Great job.
Okay, thank you for that. Well, yeah.
For me, it was all about mindset and background. So, like when you're thinking, what's going through your mind when you're on stage is like a like big thing. So like if you're thinking like, oh, how hungry you are, you might make a mistake and slip up and say something about food. So like on stage when I was a mean girl, a teacher, and Victoria, who was oblivious to this guy being in love with her. So like the mean girl, I was trying to act like, I was kind of felt a little bad, I'm sorry. I was kind of trying to feel like she was one of my siblings, because you know, it's easier to be mean to your siblings. And it's good to go to background. So like the teacher thing, all that was going through my head was, I'm stressed out, I'm tired, I got lessons playing in the grade, I got all these bad kids. So I was, and posture is good too, so I was trying to, you know, be an adult posture in a setting. Victoria, she was kind of like this oblivious, you know, the typical girl that everyone likes but don't know why they like her type thing. So I was just trying to be like aware of like feeding off their energy and stuff like that.
I tried to just like figure out like the background of my characters, or like just how they would act. That's it.
I was like, it made me feel like I was the one like never paid attention, but like when it comes to stuff like that, I tune in and then I tune back out or stuff like that. I would try to like feel like I was a, I don't know how to explain it. Nina, which was the mom, I know how like moms, old moms act and all that stuff. And since I was younger than her, it kind of felt uncomfortable, but I guess it kind of got through. I guess it kind of got through. And then the voices, it was kind of like, it made me feel like we were like visioning it, but it was really her visioning it, but we were like in her head or something like that. And so that's what.
Okay, I even thought what you said.
You were saying, so how do you stay in the moment? How do you stay in the moment?
Oh, I figure since like the whole thing's supposed to be through Brooke's point of view, I could like sit in the back, like during the long scene where I'm not talking, I sit in the back of my book and like count the words, like I'm talking. And like have my phone in the book so I can play with the black person. I don't think anybody noticed, but I
say the one that I did because I know that one only.
Okay.
So I like the one I did because it was kind of true. It's like in America, it's supposed to be just one gigantic melting pot. And although the whole premise of it is that we're supposed to accept everyone.
Well, do you guys know the thing of the melting pot? Do they know? His poem, The Melting Pot. You want to explain?
Oh, okay. So I think, so what it is, okay, sorry. I'll let him finish first, and then I'll tell you the background behind that story.
Okay, so the point of the whole melting pot, before I was interrupted, but the whole point was that everyone's supposed to come together and be united, be one, you know, we're supposed to be strong, like you have, in the melting pot, you have some, it's like one big, what's it called, stew, basically. You have some onions, some tomatoes, some sauce, some meat, yeah, just a good stew. And so it's like, although that's not how you make a traditional one, but I'm just saying, and although we're supposed to all be together, sometimes that's not what happens. Like sometimes, like right now, there's like lots of problems in America where when it comes to people of color or minorities and stuff like that. And so it's like, although the premise of it all is we're supposed to be united, but we're not that right now. And we have the, at this point, we're more inclined to just say, I don't give a D, but we're not supposed to do that. We're supposed to all continue to want to come together, not to be more apart. Yes.
So the story behind it is that Dudley Randall, like you know, many people, worked for, you know, Ford, many black people. And if you're in the first part of the 20th century, if you're black, you were more than likely to work for Ford than the other ones. You know, studies have shown that black people tended to make almost as much most of the time as white people, which was not true with the other one. So one of the things about Ford in the early 20th century is that he wanted everybody to assimilate. And there were like over 100 ethnicities that worked at Ford. So he actually had a class that if you were foreign born, you had to take this class to learn to be, you know, this American, the stereotypical kind of American. And, you know, and so changing your name might be part of it. And at the end, if you passed the class, they had this big program, and they had a big melting pot. And you would walk through the melting pot, and you would come out supposedly an American. Yeah. Okay, anybody else had a favorite Dudley Randall?
My favorite one was where they had to do the poem in front of the class. That was my favorite.
Okay.
Birmingham. Black girl. Black girl. Victoria Ward. I liked Fantasy.
Oh yeah.
Just it comes. Like, I don't know what Fantasy is.
Yeah.
I've been to the book. I actually have to read. That was a guy. And I like the Ancestors.
Okay.
Because a lot of times we think the revolution began like in the 60s and whatever, but it, you know, went backwards further as to when the slaves, like, you know, jumped over board and, like, you know, did a revolution. Yeah. I like that one.
Any other questions? Yes.
I'll put my own here. Do you guys see yourselves doing this on a larger scale somewhere, like, Fillmore or something?
Actually, I was just thinking about that on the way here. I don't know, but I was just like, you know, imagining in this park. Not in the park, but like, no, actually, like, really, like, you know, taking it in. Like,
personally, I wouldn't be like a playwright or like write screenplays, but you know, this was kind of just fun.
Yes, I would love to. Basically. Wait, what was the question?
Wait, so when you say this, are you
like just
referring
this
to
production?
This
like not
actual production or?
Oh.
Oh, yeah, because I thought you meant like just overall. That's what I was trying to like see.
Oh.
Well, you can take it both ways.
Okay, so like for this production, yes, I would love to do that. Take it bigger, make it bigger. But also just in general, I want to do this with my life, and so I would love to one day probably write something, direct something, or be in something that's bigger than like what I've done so far.
I love acting. It's kind of like what keeps me sane. So, yeah, definitely.
No, personally, I think this would be good if we could get it on a larger scale. As everybody said, I love acting and the arts in general. So.
Anybody?
Yes.
Yes. I really appreciated working with the young people. Really good. I want to applaud you for really really good to work with. And again, as I explained the last time, one of the major purposes of doing this project was we really try to develop the play so that people could do it across the country. So I'm just gonna, they had some really good ideas about making it so that it sounds more like a young person would say it. So I'm gonna make my final edits to that, and then it will be put up on the Plowshares site so that anybody can do it. They don't have to pay for it. And it's a very, very flexible play so that people can do it. So again, that's what we're striving to do, and what we're calling, this is our youth theater lab. And so this is definitely something I know that your teacher, when she was here for the other one, she said she wants to do it next year. And it definitely is something that you can continue to build on it, and so forth. So I think that's exciting. So I'm excited that your teacher wants to do it. So hopefully that will come to pass. Okay, so as I had promised, thank you for participating. And I have certificates for you all that says a certificate of achievement for being in our youth acting lab for It Speaks to Me. So. Victoria. And Adana. And Taylor. And Brenda.